Hello guys and welcome back to this channel. Today we're going to talk about equalization anatomy. Probably this video is not going to directly improve your equalization, however understanding what exactly you're doing while your equalization is definitely going to help you while you're watching another videos, whether it is my videos or someone else's videos about the topic of equalization. So this is why today we're going to use this poster to understand better which part we need to equalize, how our system works, etc. etc. So I'm pretty sure this video is going to be useful and interesting. And if you're a first time here, my name is Sergey. I'm a freediving instructor trainer, and on this channel I'm sharing with all of you guys everything what I personally know about freediving. So if you're first time here, don't forget to subscribe to this channel, don't forget to click the like button to this video and share this video among your freediving friends. And by the way guys, if you have any equalization problem or had equalization problems in the past, let me know in comments what exactly it was and how you sort it out. Okay, let's have a closer look to this poster. So this is your external canal, and then at the end of it you have an eardrum, or sometimes you can hear the name tympanic membrane, and then behind this membrane you have a middle ear space. So when you're descending, when you're going down, then this volume is going to be decreased in size, obviously, because any air space is going to squeeze on the way down. And this is why this eardrum is going to suck inside. And also remember, there's going to be a water here, which is going to push it as well. So the eardrum is relatively flexible, so initially it's going to be okay. Then maybe after a couple of meters you're going to start feeling discomfort, then it's going to be a pain, then the pain is going to be harder and harder, and then if you continue your descent without equalizing, then it's possible to damage this eardrum. So to avoid such injury, we need to equalize your airspace here. So how are we going to do it? We're going to add some air through our eustachian tube. Or, as you can see here, the name can be pharyngotympanic tube. If you want to sound smarter, you can use this terminology as well. However, most often you can hear people use eustachian tube. So eustachian tube have two parts. One part is a bone and another part is like a cartilage part. So the area where it is connected, the area where these two parts connected, it is the narrow area here. So normally it's closed. When your muscles relaxed, then this area is closed. And this is why to equalize this space, you need to create extra pressure here, and then this space, and this is going to be open, and you can equalize this space. So as you can see, this eustachian tube is going down, and then the opening of your eustachian tube is in your nasal cavity. Okay, now the first really important part. Doesn't matter which equalization you use, you're using Valsalva equalization or Frenzel equalization, you need to create extra pressure in your nasal cavity to be able to push the air up into the eustachian tube and open the eustachian tube and equalize the middle ear. So you need somehow create the extra pressure here. However, as you can see, there is not that much muscles inside this nasal cavity. This is why you could not create any external pressure right here. Where you can create the pressure is in your mouth cavity. Before that, look, between these two cavities, your nasal cavity and your mouth cavity, there is a hard palate. Okay, this is a bone. And at the end of this bone, there is a soft palate. This soft palate, this muscle tissue, is really, really crucial for freediving. Why? Because if your soft palate is closed, then doesn't matter how you increasing the pressure in your mouth cavity, in your nose cavity, the pressure will not increase, because if it's closed, the air is not coming inside the nasal cavity. So this is why while you're equalizing your ear, while you're trying to equalize your ear, the soft palate supposed to be open. And overall, what is the function of this soft palate? There is a many functions of the soft palate. For example, when you swallow the food, then the soft palate is going to be closed to prevent the food going inside your nasal cavity. So the food is going to go only into your stomach. Also, for example, when you're sneezing, then the soft palate is going to close again, preventing from this sneeze go inside your mouth. So it's pretty useful. Also, you use it like to produce different sounds. So if you're producing the sound using the nasal cavity or mouth cavity, this can position can vary. So in some people, they have a control over soft palate like originally, and for such people, the equalization is not a problem, at least this part, like to adding the air here. However, for another people, equalizing, let's say, upside down can be a problem because they couldn't control soft palate position. One of my next video is going to be about equalization problem when you're upside down and how to sort them out. So make sure you're going to check them out. All right, so now you're understanding the soft palate. We really want to have a control over soft palate. We want to keep it open while we're trying to equalize our middle ear. Okay, here you have a mouth cavity, and in your mouth cavity, obviously, you have a tongue. Originally, we were thinking that the tongue is the main muscle responsible for equalization. We were thinking that it is only one muscle. However, later, one of the freediver, Adam Stern, he did a really great experiment when he was doing the MRI. He was inside the MRI machine, and then he was checking what part exactly are moving. And what he discovered, that actually it is not only the tongue, but also the larynx is moving. And again, you can see it while you're equalizing in front of the mirror. You will see that this part is moving as well, right? So for simplicity, on my first level courses, I'm still teaching that it's mainly the tongue. But like to be more accurate, it's also the larynx as well as tongue. Okay, guys, what next? Next, you have an epiglottis. So this is a flap, consisting of different tissues, like muscle tissues, which can close this space, they close the passage to your lungs, they close the passage to your trachea. And in this case, when it's closed, everything from the mouth can go through the esophagus into your stomach. So the function of the epiglottis is when you swallow the food, making sure that the food is not going inside your lungs. Obviously, you don't want to have it. You want to have your food only going into your stomach. When we're talking about equalization, we don't really need to understand the function of epiglottis because, again, it's mainly related to the swallowing process. When you're swallowing, then the food is going into your stomach, not into your lungs, because this part is closed. For the equalization, it's more important to understand such part as your vocal cord. So your vocal cord, it is a muscle tissues, and between your vocal cord, there is a space which we call glottis. So if you don't know like how we use the glottis, how we can control the glottis, then check out my video about the Frenzel equalization, where I'm talking in details about different equalization exercises. Okay, guys, so one more time, soft palate is here. It's important to keep it open. Doesn't matter how you're equalizing, because this is going to be access to the nasal cavity and to your eustachian tube. The next one is your glottis, which is supposed to be closed while you do Frenzel equalization, and which are open while you're doing Valsalva equalization. So if you want to move to the Frenzel, you want to learn how to keep it closed while you're equalizing. Okay, guys, this is it. One more time, when we're talking about ear equalization, we're talking about middle ear equalization. It happens through the adding some air through your eustachian tube. The opening of the eustachian tube is inside your nasal cavity. There is a special tissue called soft palate, which can separate nasal cavity from mouth cavity. It's really important to learn how to keep it open. When you do Frenzel equalization, your glottis is supposed to be closed all the time. And for the equalization, we use the tongue and we use the larynx to create extra pressure inside your mouth and nasal cavity, because this is supposed to be open. Okay, guys, this is it. This was equalization anatomy. Hopefully you learned something, or maybe refresh information which you already knew. But regardless, I hope the next time when you're talking about equalization, when you're learning about equalization, now you're going to understand all the details. Okay, guys, thank you one more time for watching this video till the end, and I see you